light is shining deeper than the eyes can find it. Maybe we are made of blind souls. She tries to cover up her pain and cut her woes away, 'cause cover girls don't cry after the face is made. But there's a hope that's waiting for you in the dark. You should know you're beautiful just the way you are, and you don't have to change a thing. The world could change its heart. No scars, so you're beautiful. We're stars and we're beautiful.
My peers, and then there was me.
And a lot of people aren't afraid to give their opinions, whether they're hurtful or not.
People would laugh and stare.
People watching you eat and making little comments.
As I grew up thinking that I had to look a certain way, I never thought I was as pretty as the other girls.
I'd be proud of it. I shouldn't be trying to hide it.
Hey guys, welcome to Tiana Blanco channel, and today is a skincare routine and how I take care of my skin. Okay, so we are going to cleanse this face. And I'm gonna start off by taking off my eyelashes. Woo. I don't know if I'm ready to reveal the real me. I don't know. Okay, let's go. Fuck it. You're about to see the real me. So I'm just taking my makeup remover, my makeup eraser, and this is a rag I got from Ulta. You don't need nothing on this rag. You just need water, warm water, and that's it. So you're going to take your warm, place the rag into the warm water. And we're going to wipe away. So this rag does not need any soap. You don't need anything on this rag but water. Okay, so now we're done with this makeup rag. We are going to use, I'm gonna use my Clarisonic along with my Purity, and this is a facial cleanser. You just wanna squeeze a little bit of that facial cleanser onto the brush. Now, once we are done with that, then you want to dip this rag back into warm water and wipe your face. I'm just going to take my Nivea lotion. It depends on whether it's nighttime and I'm going to sleep. I like to use coconut oil, organic coconut oil. Or if it's in the daytime, then I'm going to use the Nivea lotion. And I say the coconut oil for nighttime because it's been oily. So, because it's really oily. And, you know, you don't want to go outside like that. And it's about to be summertime. And whenever placing anything on your face, such as lotion, you don't want to just drag it down because then that creates wrinkles. So you want to just kind of smooth it out and bring it upwards. Oh, so this is all me. Dead ass ugly. So this video is just more so, you know, embracing your beautifulness. okay? Embracing the art that God has created. Whether you have marks on your skin, whether you have acne, breakouts, whatever it is. Because me, I have chicken pox. And let me just zoom in so I can show you guys. So this is my skin with no product on it. And I have a few marks on my face due to chicken pox. So kind of embrace your flaws, okay? Don't be worried about, oh my God, this person only see me with makeup and I look so good with makeup. No, because without that makeup, this is what God has created, okay? So that is the most beautiful thing. When applying makeup or when you want your makeup done and you want this flawless face, it starts with your skin, okay? So you want to take care of this. You want to take care of God's art right here. You can exfoliate or do a facial about twice a week. You don't want to exceed it any more than 3 times a week because anything too much is too bad for you, okay? And you don't want your skin to dry up or just react to too much of that exfoliating or facials or whatever you're going to use. So you want to do about 2-3 times the most a week. And another thing is also cleaning your brushes. So when applying makeup or having your makeup done by someone else, please be sure to look at their brushes before applying it to your face. A lot of makeup brushes hold germs, okay? It holds a lot of germs because we don't clean it, we don't deep clean it as much as we should. So before you do your own makeup or have someone else do your makeup, please be sure to check the brushes. Make sure it's clean. The next one I would recommend is also just finding a good facial cleanser. Me personally, I use several different ones. I don't have, you know, a specific one to where I can say this is what I like. But I do like Neutrogena brand. Neutrogena has a variety of skincare products. So you can use that. You can use a facial cleanser that is good for you. And also something that is hypoallergenic. If you have sensitive skin like myself, I have to find products that are hypoallergenic. So I like to use Neutrogena. Also, Kiko have a good skincare line as well. So those are the two that I kind of stick with. Another thing that I recommend is also making sure when you're done your makeup for the night and you come in the house and you're ready to crash and go to sleep, please be sure to wipe off that makeup. I don't care how beat that goddamn face is. You have to wipe it off because all that makeup is just digging into your skin and building it up. And all that makeup is just clogging your skin pores. So you want to, you know, wipe that off and just have a fresh face. No matter how beat that face is, how much money you pay for that face, please wipe that face before you go to bed. And, you know, other than that, then, I mean, any other skin conditions that I'm not too familiar on how to take care of skin conditions, because me personally, I never had really bad acne growing up, but my sister has, so I understand it, and it's like fucking annoying. But you, and then you work in to see what product works for you. But once you find that product that works for you, stick with it.